Human Digestive System Part 2. How the food is taken, digested and absorbed. Objectives. By the end of this video, you will be able to explain the functioning of digestive system in human being as well as explain the enzymatic action on the food at different levels of elementary canal. In the last video, we have learnt about the different parts of digestive system. We have also learnt that it includes elementary canal and digestive glands. Now, let us learn how it works and why the food has to be digested. The food which we take contains complex food components such as carbohydrates, proteins, and lipids. These complex substances cannot be directly assimilated into the tissue levels. Hence, they have to be digested. Carbohydrates are digested to form glucose. Proteins are digested to form amino acids, whereas lipids are digested to form fatty acids and glycerol. The digestive system functions at four stages such as ingestion, digestion, absorption and defecation. When the food is taken into the oral cavity, it is cut and crushed with the teeth. And with the help of tongue, it is mixed with the saliva, which is secreted by salivary glands. Saliva contains an enzyme called amylase or ptyalin. The action of amylase converts carbohydrates into maltose sugars. After completion of this work, the food starts traveling through the pharynx and esophagus to reach the stomach. The food always travels through the elementary canal by peristaltic movement, which is generated by the movement of or contraction of muscles in the elementary canal. And now the food enters into the stomach through the sphincter. The churning movement of the stomach grinds the food properly. The stomach walls contain gastric glands which secrete gastric juice containing hydrochloric acid and an enzyme called pepsin. Hydrochloric acid kills the bacteria as well as it creates acidic medium to facilitate the protein digestion. The enzyme action of pepsin converts proteins into peptide chains or peptones. After a period of time, the food enters into the duodenum through the pyloric sphincter. Duodenum receives the secretions from liver and pancreas. Liver secretes bile juice, which does not contain any enzymes, but it contains bile pigments and bile salts. Bile salts convert the medium into alkaline to facilitate the digestion of carbohydrates and lipids, whereas bile pigments help in emulsification of lipids. This facilitates the digestion of lipids. Pancreas secretes pancreatic juice, which contains trypsin, lipase, and amylase. Lipase converts lipids to fatty acids and glycerol. Trypsin converts peptones into amino acids, whereas amylase converts carbohydrates and other sugars into glucose. After completion of this action, the food moves further and reaches the long and highly coiled portion of small intestine, the walls of which contain intestinal glands, which secrete intestinal juices containing several enzymes like peptidases, sucrases, etc. These enzyme action ensures the complete digestion of carbohydrates, proteins and fats. And also the small intestine contains finger-like projections called villi in its inner surface. These are highly entangled with the blood capillaries and lined with a single layer of epithelial cells. Hence, the digested food is easily absorbed into the bloodstream, from which it is supplied to all the body parts. Finally, the undigested food enters into the large intestine. While moving along through the large intestine, the extra amount of water in the food is absorbed back into the body. And finally, the undigested food, which is called as feces, it will travel through the rectum and finally expelled out through the anal pore. This process is known as defecation. Summary. With this video, We have explained the functioning of human digestive system under four stages, such as ingestion, digestion, absorption, and defecation. Also explained the enzyme action on different components of food, such as carbohydrates, proteins, and lipids. And also learnt about their digestion into glucose, amino acids, fatty acids, and glycerol. We have also explained that the food is digested from complex substances to simple substances to facilitate the assimilation of these food substances into the body.